Hey, talofa lava everyone, malo lava, le soifua malilangi mama, pula manaka, whakalafa I atu, malo le lelei, what else is there? Nisa pula manaka, kia rana, and kia ora to everyone. Hey, Taumaloto tete here, coming to you guys live from Christchurch. I am of the class of 2002, and welcome to the Hot Sauce. Hopefully you guys are having a great day, wherever you guys may be. Hopefully there's no more tornadoes. Man, what about that? I saw a video of some trampoline going throwing, flying around. You know, things that we see in news, but it's happening right here in New Zealand. Hey, hopefully everyone's taking care of themselves, eh? Hey, we've got a great show on tonight. Tonight, we're going to be changing things up a little bit. Usually, we have a teacher that's going to be jumping onto the hot sauce, jumping onto the hot seat, and we ask them the hot questions. But because it's the last week of school, okay, last week of term, and I know it's been a crazy year so far with this whole COVID-19, and I know that teachers are working hard to try and get credits for our kids. We thought we'll give them a break. Let's just stop, let's pause, and let's just review. Guess what? 2 months ago, we decided, me and Marshy, to do this kind of show, and we've done 16 shows already. This is our 17th show, believe it or not. Who would have guessed? But hey, we're just going to roll on with the with our little video, then we'll pop back and then we'll continue to talk, eh? Let's go. Again, Tala Falava, Taumaloto Tietia here. Welcome to the Hot Sauce for another Wednesday. Usually we have a teacher that will be popping on really soon and we'll interview them, but hey, it's busy. It's busy. Marshy can't be with us tonight because he has a Māori hui or a Māori meeting at Tangaro College. Yes, they're having a meeting to try and get their land back at the back of Tangaro College. Get their land back. But you need to give back the muskets and the guns. But never mind, they got the hui on tonight, so he won't be with us. He'll be tuning in a little bit later, if possible. But again, today is a review day. It's a review time. A couple of months ago in February, Marshy actually came down to me here in Christchurch, and we spoke about trying to get something online. How can we connect to our alumni using this online platform? He looked at me and goes, how can we do it? I looked at him, and I go, I do not know. But guess what? We sat on it, and then out of nowhere, the man himself, Mr. Terry Nelson, he returned back to Tangaro College. And he has the connections. He's one of those Māoris with the connection. He got all these great connections. And he goes, you know what? I got this program that we can use. Gave it to Marshy. Marshy told me at 11 o'clock one night, jump on, let's check this out. And boom, the ketchup was born. The hot sauce was born. And any other Pepelo show that we're going to come up was born. But guess what? It's been an awesome show. Again, this is our 17th show between the hot sauce and the ketchup. It's always been me and Marshy, but we decided a couple of weeks ago we'll bring on another host. So that host is going to be jumping on with us right now. So wherever you may be, please put your hands together and please welcome in Miss Carmel. Savai na ya. Hey sis, how are you?
Oh, shucks. Hey, still I'm good, out. Man. Yeah, still working out from last week. Hey, how's it going?
Stop breathing heavily, sis.
My mic is too close to my mouth. Is this a good angle of me? Yeah, no, that's all right. I can see my split.
We can see your nose, yeah.
Hey, it's good to be back again. Sir? Not too bad. I've got a couple more days left of school before the term ends, so yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Yeah. And yourself?
Nice. So, yeah. Oh, awesome. It's. I don't know about you guys in Auckland, but it's bloody freezing here in Christchurch. It is cold.
Yeah. I heard you talking about the flying trampolines. We had a bit of a tornado on the south side in the weekend. Yeah, saw an image of a trampoline just hugging the pole. Eh? That was unreal.
Yeah. Wow. Well, that's stuff that we see on the movies. We never thought that it will happen here.
Yeah, Hado. I haven't heard anyone report about the undies go missing off the washing line, but hey, If someone's flagged, landed in your backyard, yes, probably tells from Christchurch.
Hey, stop it. Hey, again, welcome, Carmel-maria, to our show. What we're going to do now, we usually do a photo segment, but we thought, you know what, it's a great opportunity for us to throw up all the posters of all the shows and let us talk to it. So if there are anything, shows that you might have missed, you know, to our viewers that are viewing it now, you might be going, hey, I didn't know that that show was there. Well, guess what? It was here, and it'll be a good time for us to reminisce, sis, and just, yeah, let's go from there. So let's
is a lagging.
Just started with me and Marshy. Me and Marshy come up first. So we kicked off the first ever Ketchup. It was awesome to be able to see a lot of our people mock us, or, you know, we're able to talk about the good times. And
Sis,
I'll bring you back in.
Yeah, cool.
Oh, did you? Oh, mate, this was the first ever one that we did back in May.
Okay, is it still up? Is everything still up on the page? Like, if you missed
everything
it,
is still up on the So if you missed it, this is the first ever one that me and Marshy did, and then from there, we introduced the Ketchup, and this was our first crew that jumped onto the Ketchup.
Yeah,
we have the class of 2009. We had Mary Jane, Kivalu. She joined us from Timaru at the time, but she's currently based in Otago. We had the man himself, Samson Rambo. We had Beulah Kuale. He beamed in from Hawaii.
Hawaii.
We had Musi Afua, MMA fighter, Fitalinga, which is working in marketing.
It's lagging on my side, eh? So if I don't answer you, it's because Auckland. I think it's your fight.
Yeah. Do you remember anything about the show, sis?
Yeah. Sorry, I sort of missed everything. It was lagging. I don't know if it's you or me. I know I've got 5G happening in Otara. I know about Christchurch. But yeah, I remember that. I remember that show. Those guys were pretty hesitant. I remember they were hesitant to spill the tea, and go all in. But yeah, Mary Jane, I remember her from school. Her sister Hinemoa is actually my year. Yeah, so we're the same year. And man, those guys, they're so humble, eh? They're actually quite up there and the stuff that they know of the fighting, Mary Jane and what she's doing, Samson Beulah, but they're very humble guys. But they're actually really famous. I think they didn't give themselves enough credit. But if you don't know who they are, or you know who they are, but you actually don't know how big they are on, you know, a worldwide sort of scale, check it out, man. They're big names. And yeah, they've got so much more to go and to do in terms of like what they're doing. So yeah, that was really cool to see them. And hear their stories and hear them just be humble about themselves, eh? It's really cool. Cool to see some Otara kids making it out in the big world. And we are lagging. Was it just me? Is it you? Should I just keep talking for the sake of it? Anyway, guys, while we're waiting for it to come up, is my hair looking all right? Do we have any Otara hairdressers out there who can fix up my split ins? Oi, my lost split ins. Yes, no. Make sure you comment below so that I can go and get my hair sussed out. Are we laggy? Hello, do you hear me? Anyways, that's what I remember of them. Samson, I'm gonna keep talking until I see some action from Tal's side. But what's it called? Yeah. Samson Rambo, he's done some mean like video clips for singers. He's done some like real short films. Check him out. I think he goes under Samson Rambo on social media. Hey, and I have the screen to myself. Is this because it wasn't me lagging? Anyway, back to my hair, guys. Look at this. Split ends. If you can help me out, please comment below on where I can get my split ends sussed out. It's looking a little bit dry. So yeah, I'm going way off topic, but that's all right. I'm just enjoying the view right now. But yeah, anyway, that was the class of 2009. I just want to make a massive shout out to Mr. Marsh, wherever you are. Apparently he's at a local hui at Tangaroa College. As Tal said, they're trying to get their land back so they can build a marae for Tangaroa College.
Is hey, sorry about that. Sorry about that, sis. Can you hear me now?
Yeah, yeah, it's all good. I was just plugging any salons in Otara, any hairdressers that can fix up my split ends, if that's all right.
Now, that's awesome. Hey, hey, we spoke about 2009. Then we started a show called The Hot Sauce, which is just me and Marshy being random one night, and we thought that we'll throw teachers. And our first guest that we had up was Mr. David Riley. Mr. David Riley, yes, which is an English teacher that's been at Taumaloto College for over 20 years. He shared his story about growing up in Mangere, being this white boy that grew up there, and how he started teaching Sunday school in Otara. And then from there, he
had a
teacher called Miss Mangere, which he ended up having to choose two schools. So he either had to teach at Kiaroha, which is Clover Park, or at Taumaloto College. And he spoke about how Mr. Jim Peters gave him his first job. And he was been at Taumaloto College ever since. And then he spoke about his journey as an author into Reading Warrior. So hopefully a lot of you guys have been able to pick up a lot of his material. He got a book called How Tonga Was Named with Chad Robinson. And also Juliana Faletang, which was all part of the class of 2005. So yeah, we went from the hot sauce, then we went over to, we had the class of 2003 on. That was the likes of Terry Nelson, we had Ben Reamer, we had Michael Siva, and we had Daniel Hollis-Cone. And that was awesome. They were the guys with the rugby jerseys, and they did the practicing with the balls. So that was an awesome kōrero there. And then we had on the hot sauce, because of New Zealand Music Month, we had David Sautupe, aka The Movement, join us.
Yeah, true. Right, I missed that one.
Yeah, he spoke about his journey being a rapper over here with the likes of Poetic. You know, they're part of that Machete district.
Yeah.
So he's you're Poetic, and then he spoke about his song as a master that got picked up for Hobson Shaw.
Yes.
Yeah, so
but you know what? I reckon they got ripped off, man. They should have played that like loud and clear and
exactly.
Yeah, but anyway, so it was there. You had to put your earphones in and rewind it to play, but man.
Oh, tell me about it. I watched that. I went to the movies to watch it just for that.
Yeah.
And I had to look around going, I think I missed it.
Was it before The Rock was doing his Samoa?
Yeah, it must have been. His balafu. But hey, we had David Sautupe. Then we had, the class of 2000. We had the likes of Antoinette, Simon. We had Doogie, Joseph Jumpin, and also Candy. Niuean group, Candy. Group of 2000.
And I
remember that year because they spoke about, if people don't know, Taumaloto College was actually meant to close down in the mid-90s because our role actually ended up under 200. So when I started at Taumaloto College in 98, there was only one Form 7 class. And that Form 7 class was only, I think, 15 of them. And I remember that because that was my oldest year. What's that?
Where did people from Otara go for school? Did they go to Hillary or?
No, they were all going out to like De La Salle. They were going out to Macaulay. Because I remember when I was at school, that's what everyone was doing. You know, Edgewater. Because there was that stigma, right? That, don't send your kid to Taumaloto College. You'll get nowhere.
Yeah.
So a lot.
Hey, you know what's funny is.
Yeah.
Oh, well, not funny, but my family on my dad's side, they actually wanted me to go to like Auckland Girls or Mags because they stayed out those ways. But I was like, nah, man, I want to go to Taumaloto College. That's where my brother goes. And I used to think it was so cool, he'll come home. You know, he'd either be in trouble for something he did at school. And actually thought it was cool, but it wasn't. But I was like, nah, I don't want to go to Auckland Girls World. Those days, what I knew was South Auckland and where I was comfortable. And so it was like a goal for me. Some people, I know some people aspire to go to university and all that stuff. My goal was to make it to Tangaroa College. So, yeah, it's interesting that you say that Tangaroa was the goal for me.
Yeah. And again, I think something that everyone said was Tangaroa College wasn't the first option for everyone. You know, for like people like myself, it was the only option. You know, and I'm cool with that. But I know for a lot of people, if they had the opportunity, they would have went to other schools. And then I've heard that a lot of people say, you know what, I'm actually thankful that I did not go to other schools. And that was awesome, you know, having the class of 2000 on. And then I think we went on to, with the hot sauce, we had Wilson Marsh, Brian's brother, Marshy's brother.
Yeah, he joined
us from the Gold Coast. And that's awesome. You know, people that know the Marsh family, 10 siblings. Yeah. You know, but the bottom two, which is Wilson Marsh and Brian Marsh, and the impact that they've had at Tangaroa College over the last 20 plus years has been huge. So that was awesome to hear about what he's doing over in the Gold Coast as a teacher and also with his outreach, sports outreach. So that was awesome to hear from Wilson Marsh. And then from there, we actually went to the class of the early 90s. The early 90s, which was Efeso College, or Councillor Banana Efeso College, which is a councillor for on our Auckland City, Auckland was Super City. You had Akarei Malesala, which was an ex-cop, and he started a business called My River App, you know, for mental health. You also had likes of Cherry Seal. He popped in as well. Ex-Warrior, ex-Kiwi player. He also is working with the Warriors as their youth development officer. And we also had Elder Natua. She was the one that kind of got all of these guys on. So that was an awesome kōrero. Just hearing about the stories back then in the early 90s and what Tangaroa College pretty much looked like. So that was awesome. Man,
I definitely got to go back and watch it, man.
Yeah, go back and watch these shows, and mostly
from the 90s when I was still in primary.
And some of the stories that they go on about, you actually say to yourself, oh, is that why the school got shut down? Was going to get shut down?
Yeah.
some of the stuff that they did, you know, not in a bad way, but some of the stuff that they, you know, it was awesome for people to reflect. And then we had the Famuina's on, Emmaleta and Penny Famuina.
Pastor
Penny Famuina, now of Otara
Baptist Church.
And also Emmaleta Famuina, which wasn't head of English, but now she's a deputy principal.
Wow, that's so cool, man. Yeah. When I was in school, she was my English teacher, I think in seventh form or something. I remember doing an assessment. I was going through a tough time at that time, and we had to do an assessment on King Lear. We had to do a speech or act something out, and I actually got drunk and performed a piece from that, and I got a merit for it. And one of the girls in my class picked up a fuss about it. Was like, "Mashi, I was drunk." Blah 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 blah. But Mashi was so cool. She was understanding, and she was just like, "Hey." At the end of the day, she did the work and she deserved the grade that she got. So, but she's been awesome. But not to promote that you should do that, but I mean, you know.
Yeah, you shouldn't do that. Come on. Far out.
Shucks. That's why I'm sharing the story so that, you know, if you're going through a hard time, alcohol is not the way.
Yeah, Jesus is the way. Thank you.
That's truth and life. Anyway, moving on to what?
Yeah, and then the next show on the Ketchup, we had the class of 2005, which was Basilea Mulianga, another tapu. Then we had Chad Robinson, which was an artist. He worked with Mr. Riley.
Worked with Mr. Riley on
his book. So for you guys out there, readingwarrior.com, jump on, get those books. illustrated by TC's own.
Yep.
Then we had Philomena.
Chad's got his own comic book. Chad's got his own comic book.
Yes.
The Long White Cloud. Oh, wait, long.
Yes.
Not the alcohol drink.
I was like,
Not Long White, The Long White Cloud. I think, yeah, is what it's called. It's an awesome comic book with our own Basfika superheroes and everything. And he's done it all himself. So grab that if you need to, hit him up. I think he goes by Silver Ink on Instagram or something. It's his IG handle.
Silver Ink. Oh, me.
Mm.
Yep. Well, now we know. Yeah, we also had Philomena Inivali. She's over in Singapore, working over there. Me. And we had Itawini Beeman from, he's teaching over in Brisbane. Nice. Then we had Juliana Faletau. Their family are the ones that got, on Preston with the...
Yes.
If you want a warrant...
His little brothers are drummers, eh?
Yes. So she's there. She's currently doing her PhD. So heaps of great shows for you guys to bump onto. Yeah. If you guys haven't, man, we've just had heaps of fun. I enjoyed the following Hot Sauce where we interviewed Miss Auntie Nga and Miss Rossella Lafaeli.
Yeah. I remember Auntie Nga's sandwiches that she used to make. Because I remember when, I think when Miss Ashmore was still principal. So we had to do the sneakies at the side window. She was do her sandwiches over there. She had the bombest rolls and sandwiches.
Oh, wow. Yeah, she's a legend. In my eyes, I believe she's the mama of TC, and rest in peace to her late husband, Siwa, which I believe is the papa of TC. But yeah, Auntie Nga, he passed away.
Oh,
he's been sick for a while, but yeah.
Yeah.
But he's in a better place. Wow. So yeah, Auntie Nga and Miss Lafayette, you can't separate them if you're ever at TC. These two are like sisters. It's awesome. And then on the Ketchup, we actually had the class of 2006, and that was brought to us by Crucial Flooring. But as Marshy will say, Critical Flooring. But it's Crucial Flooring.
It's false advertising right there.
Yeah, man. One of the brothers, he's got a business, and he sponsored this show, which is awesome, which is class of 2006. Well, we had Brandon Jackson. We had
Arnhem. He sponsored?
Yeah, he sponsored the show. So he gave us a bit of money, and that just helps pay for the overheads of running this, paying for subscriptions and stuff. Yeah.
A shameless plug right now. If people want to sponsor a show to keep it up and running for however, are they able to do that still? How do they just get in touch with you guys?
So we got the email down the bottom. Tangaroa College Alumni at gmail.com, or hit us up on Facebook if you got a bit of money, if you want to plug your business or whatever. Hey, all this just helps us with the overheads of running this. A lot of this is coming out of our own pocket, but hey, we do it for the love of TC. But yeah, on 2006, it was brought to us by Crucial Flooring. And it was awesome. We had Brandon Jackson, we had Adam come to us from Timaru, we had Mons with her little.
She sang.
Yeah, she sang her song.
Yeah.
And then we had Terry Toki and Ilisala Tietia. And that was, awesome show.
I remember watching that one.
Yeah. I just love the insight that these two groups have brought, like 2005, 2006.
Yeah. Like, another crazy group that were holding back on the shade, eh? When they saw the photos and they want to say something, they go,
Yeah. Yeah,
let me just say something. If your class is about to come on here, please don't laugh and then hold back, man. Just let it go. There's no guidelines or anything of what you can and can't say. You're not in school anymore. The gates are open. You don't need an exit note. Just go for it.
Oh, just be like 2009 and spill the beans about when they got stoned at camp, snow camp. Yeah, Viola and Samson.
I remember told us a story
how they were left at the pools. Literally left at the pools.
By their teachers?
A couple of them decided to go score some weed. And apparently they had enough weed for the week. And a lot of them that had not smoked weed before pretty much got high. And man, only at TC, eh? Only at TC.
You got to be smart. See, we got a lot of ninjas at Tangaroa College.
Ninjas.
It's an art. Don't, it's a skill.
Don't hold back, man. Tell us. But again, it was awesome to have Luktu Fuli come to us on the hot sauce. Hey, round of applause to Luktu Fuli. If you guys haven't heard, she's been selected to be part of Jacinda's labor team to go and So I think
that is
running. I think she's running for Botany South. The touch wood, something like that. But yeah, she's part of labor. She's being called in. So hopefully we can see one of our own TC in Parliament. So elections coming up, we've got an AFI our own. So it was awesome
she's
for her.
She's all about the community, man. She's actually about it. A lot of us, you know, there are a lot of people out there who talk about it, but she talks about it and she bees about it too, man. And that's what we need more of. Not people that just talk the talk, but actually walk it too. Wow, that's awesome. Congratulations.
Yeah, and for those that don't know, Luktu Fuli was an ex-student at Tangaroa College, and then she came back as a teacher. She was my history teacher. Then she went on to overseas, she was saying, to teach in Korea and Japan. Then she came back and she decided to go back to law school. She is a lawyer at the moment, and she also works as a politician. Or not works, but as a politician, she sits as the chairperson of the Otara and Papatoa local board. And so a lot of the changes that we're seeing in the hood, like Ngati Otara, all those changes, that's all coming from pretty much the movement of our own people. They got her, you got the likes of Efeso Collins, all from Tangaroa College.
It's cool. We have like, we've had, what you said, 17 shows, eh? And there's been like people from that are out there making changes on a larger scale who people see on billboards and on TV and all that sort of stuff. And then we have the likes of those who are just out there working silently and making big damages as well. The likes of like Candy and what was that class? Candy and Simon and them?
Yeah, 2000.
Out there in the community that support, they're out there in the Clover Park Community House doing their stuff over there that doesn't get advertised all over TV. But it's cool to see that we got people out there on the big screens and just on your phone that you can see on Facebook. That's amazing.
Yeah. I even like the range that we've had. So we've had the clubs of, you know, the 2000s. We've gone into the 90s. And in 1 week, I think I was on the 20th of June, we actually went to the class of 1980.
How was that?
Yeah, it was awesome. So we had Christine Richards, which is Marshy's sister. And we had Daryl Tua, which is Joe Tua, Mr. Tua's older brother. He beamed in from Alice Springs in the Northern Territory somewhere in Australia. So that was awesome. And we also had Joe Nelson bump in. So these are people from, they finished in 1980. So they're all foundation students.
Shucks.
At Tangaroa College, and they were sharing about families that they know. They're talking about back then how there were farmhouses
that went to
they went back. They explained how they used to go to the back at where the cows are. They used to go pick up mud and throw it at the cows. It was awesome. Talanoa there from the class of 1980. And then last week, and then, that's nearing. And then last week on Wednesday, I was privileged enough to talk to Nadine Papali, Ms. Papali. The Papali
family.
Awesome
chat.
For those that know the Papali family in Otara, big family, Dad Poutua. He's done a lot of community work as well, along with her mum. So she was a student that went on to become an engineer. But she always had inkling to always teach. So she jumped on the Teach First program. She was one of the first in the Teach First program, and she came back and taught at Tangaroa College 7 years. Mm. 7 years she's been teaching at TC as a maths teacher, working in technology. She headed up our health science academy. And then she spoke about how she's taking a group of four kids over to America, to Alabama, to space camp.
Space camp. You know what, man? That is so cool. I mean, I remember being in school and like not even thinking about, you know, wanting to be an astronaut or even to think about. To me, that was like a Palangi thing. And because I didn't have those conversations around me growing up, I didn't have people talking about space and all these other engineering jobs and stuff. I couldn't visualize that for myself. And so to have someone like, is it Nadine? Ms. Papali? To have someone like her to come and be like, hey, here's something that is absolutely possible for you to be, for you to experience. Like, man, the possibilities are just like, you know, just so wild for students these days. Because before I could, you know, think about was being like a youth worker or a social worker, people that I worked, you know, that helped me as a teenager. I didn't see people or hear people talk about things like space and engineering and all of that. So I couldn't see myself becoming one of those things. So for her to have those conversations in her classroom, bring that sort of vibe into Taumaloto College, that's amazing. I love that. I love that. Such an amazing person. Yeah.
Yeah. And I think that was another heart of, you know, for, I know for me and myself and Marshy and the likes of Renee Tuffy about starting this alumni thing was for our people to find out what's happening at Taumaloto College, but also people from Taumaloto, you know, but also for us to hear, you know, for us to hear what's happening at TC through our teacher, but also for us to hear from each other, because it's kind of like we overlap, you know. It's awesome to hear the stories of the class of 2005, 2006, then going to guys like Efeso and them, the early 90s, going back to the early 80s. You know, and hearing the progression of where our school has actually come from. We've gone through some hard times, we've gone through some good times. And it's awesome. And then last week on Saturday, we're privileged to have the class of 2008. Yes. We had all our groups, they jumped in from Australia.
Mm-hmm.
And that was an awesome Talanoa as well. And Carmel, if you can explain a little bit more about that Talanoa.
Yes, so we had Lole Siokata, we had Marcus Kitione, we had Letitia Stowers. We did have Robert, who joined us for closing prayer at the end. But yeah, we had those guys and they came on. They talked about what they were up to, things like Marcus being like the rep for the LGBTQIA, I think.
Oh, wow.
Somewhere along the alphabet, just choose a letter. So those sorts of things. Lole still keeping up with his performing arts and filming. Letitia getting back into the sports because, man, she had one of the quickest feet back in 2008 and when she was younger. Yeah. So yeah, we had those guys jump on. They had so many. They were so vulnerable in the things that they were sharing.
Yeah.
That a lot of golden nuggets. So if you didn't catch that live, the podcast it's on the page. So yeah, catch that one if you haven't. And that was also my introduction. So if you want to see my cool video, get on there. But it's not about me. It's about you guys. So I'll start talking about myself.
Yeah. It's
yeah. Not, but they were awesome, man. Yeah. Class of 2008.
Yeah, and again, guys, to our viewers and all of those, all of the stuff is there on the page. Just go through and watch it back. Like, there's some shows, and I'm just being honest, that I don't watch back ASAP. I wait for a couple of days or even a couple of weeks, and I'll go back and I'll watch it. And, man, it's just awesome taking those gems, you know, from the Talanoa that we've had, just learning history. If you guys want to learn the TC history, I can't tell you anything because I wasn't there. Or, you know, we can't because we weren't there, you know, at that time. We got our own slice of history that we are wanting to share. But if you want some real, you know, nuggets, go back. And there are a lot of nuggets that you can take and you can put on your teeth and you can have gold teeth. Thank you very much.
Are we sponsored by McDonald's tonight? Because all these nuggets.
Hey, but on that note, but on that note, we're just going to play a little video. A couple of weeks ago, we shared a video about our merchandise that we dropped. Thank you to our partnership with Dynasty. Man, we got this awesome merchandise out there for you guys to purchase. People are asking questions. Let's just play the video and we'll come back and we'll run through, are they?
Let's go.
Sweet ass. Whoa, beam video.
Did it play?
I just blinked in.
Oh.
I just blinked in. It was. Sweet. So I think I have one more page round A. I think I'll grab me one of the next
period. Yeah. Gonna so again, for the blue those are our merchandise that we're dropping now. There are other merchandise like Leathermans and polo shirts and all of that, but we'll run that through. We'll just stagger it because the last thing that we want is we'll put everything out and then it was a logistical nightmare on our end, so we'll just slowly roll it out. So
logistical nightmare.
Yeah, you know.
Taumaloto.
Yeah, mainframe.
I'm gonna write that one on logistical nightmare.
But again, guys, the cutoff is on the 17th of July. Please get your orders in, email us and we'll send out the order form. Then you'll get an invoice and I'll have the bank account details for you to pay your money into. If you want to pay in installments, please just get a hold of us. And that way we can track it. But 17th of July, please.
Yeah.
And there is a minimum order of 10 jumpers each that we need. We have reached that. It's the beanies. We need people to buy about another 10. And then we can put this order through. So please do not hold back. If you got any questions, hit us down the bottom. But Carmel, did you have a question there?
No, it was just a comment. I was going to say, hey, you know what? Pay your child support first and then get yourself a jumper, okay?
Yeah.
Kids need to eat out there.
Yeah, priorities, eh? Priorities.
Priorities.
Okay, you don't want to be wearing your jumper. You don't want to be wearing your jumper while you're eating your noodles. Priorities.
But hey,
we've gone back. We've looked at all the awesome shows that we've had up. I'll be honest with you, when me and Marshy talked about this, we only expected this to last for a month. We've gone on for 2 months, and guess what? Next month is packed out again. So next month we got... So there's no show this week. There's no show this Friday because it's the last week, and we thought we'll give everyone time with their family. So no catch up this week.
Hey, stop lying. Mr. Marshy and the teaching staff of Tangaro College are...
They got a party
and won't be able to make the show. Let's not lie to our people, man. Sorry. Come on, they deserve the truth.
Yeah, so Mashi's got other priorities, which is fine. I think he's earned that. So,
definitely.
I got Bible study. So, So on that note, there'll be no show this Friday. Hot Sauce will be taking a 2-week break as well. Okay, 2-week break because of the school holidays. So we're going to give the teachers a break with their kids. Yeah. So, and then on the Ketchup, we got the GC crew coming on. So we've got a group of people from TC that are on the Gold Coast. You got Miriana, you got Renee, you got Simone. There's a group of them, Lambros.
That
crew out in the GC, they're going to be jumping on with Wilson Marsh, I think. So we got the GC group, then we got the 2003 girls. So we had the 2003 boys with Terry and them. Now the 2003 girls want to jump on and spill the beans.
That one might be a bit dangerous, eh? Or the female's going to come out and
Growl. That's Agnes Joanne and them. And then we got the class of 2004.
Hello, Tile.
So this is an awesome, this is an awesome, awesome group. 2004. You got Michael Tapu. You got Constantine Dombos, which is the head boy.
Oh.
He's a pilot. He's a pilot for Air New Zealand. You got Cathy Zombos.
Those two were always together, eh?
Yeah. You got his twin sister, which is now a pastor, Eddie Cooper's. Then you got Dr. Mataroria Linden that's jumping on.
Hey, can I just say, Michael, Mataroria, and Con?
Yeah.
They're always together, man. Everyone, all the girls had a crush on them, like all at the same time. They were the hotties back in high school, I tell you that. So if you want some eye candy, make sure you tune in and see that one, okay?
Yeah.
But they're all happily married, just so you know.
Oh, Con's not. Con's not. And he'll never be married.
Just put me his email and
the Con that I know will never get married. Okay, and then after that, we've got the class of 2007.
Yes, that's my class.
Yeah, we've got the class of 2007. So that's July taken care of. On the hot sauce, we got a couple of people. We got Prem Krishna, Mr. Prem Krishna, that did AE, ex-New Zealand basketball
player.
Yeah.
Yes.
So Prem Krishna will be jumping on the hot sauce. And also Mr. Joe Tua will be jumping on the hot sauce. So that's for July, guys. We already got July. Putting it out there. If you guys want to jump on the show, I'm putting it out there to my brother, Tautianga Tiatia, class of 1998. Can you please get us a group? Tautianga Tiatia, if you can get us a group for the hot sauce, that would be awesome. And I also put it out there for my group. There's no point all these other guys bringing groups. So 2002, Saikaloni Taufa, Raymond Brown, Owen Ikimotu, find a couple of girls. Imele, find a couple of girls. We're going to get the class of 2002.
That was the year of the first 15, eh? First 15,
So the thing is that if you guys want to jump on, if you guys got any questions, please jump on below. But, hey, aside from that, Carmel's doing her weights. Her muscles and her fingers is... but aside from that, hey, that's our show for tonight. If you guys got any questions, again, merchandise, 17th of July. Please do not come to me and cry and go, oh, can I get my order in? Because I will say, how old are you?
Direct them to Raylon. We're like, hey, you know what? You want an offer? Go to Raylon and then get a Vivid and then just TC alumni by yourself of your twink.
Yeah. You don't want to be that one. You want to have the legit gear. So please, all that. July, the hope is that once we come to August, we're going to start staggering on the shows on Friday night, so we'll no longer have the hot sauce on Wednesday. Just gives us a break. So
you
we'll start staggering
the
hot
sauce
and the ketchup. Again, we had no idea that this will go on this long, but this is what, this is the Lord's work, I believe. And as Wilson Marsh reminded us, it is a ministry. It's a good way of connecting with our fellow alumni. And hopefully you guys have enjoyed these shows as much as we have. Hopefully you guys have taken something away and just had a laugh. You know, aside from everything that we've done, hopefully you guys have had a laugh. Any last words, Carmel?
Not much. I just want to make a big shout out to those who have been commenting on the group. Shout out to Agnes Ioane, aka Tile. You know what was up back in school, if people start calling you by your mom or dad's names. Shout out to Tile there. Anthea, what's up, Mons? Sakaloni, Upper Dawson, what? Miss Lasella, Matthew McFarlane, again, on last week on Saturday, that last name came up, McFarlane. Auntie Regina. Yeah, and everyone else that's joined us, man, shout for coming through, and to those who are going to watch it later. I do want to say just a massive shout-out to Tau and Marshy for providing this platform. Of course, a lot of people have come through. 17 shows in 2 months. Man, that is massive. You've made a platform, and people have just been coming in, and that's all from you guys just having an idea, running with it and actioning it. So thank you so much for providing this platform for people to come through to reminisce, to talk about what TC is all about. Despite all the negativity and everything, man, we've had some heavy hitters come on the shows. If you haven't seen it or haven't, if you've missed out a few shows, make sure you scroll through the Tangaroa College alumni page and all the lives are posted on there. So, yeah, thank you so much, Sau and Marshy, for this opportunity for people to come through and connect to Tangaroa again.
Cheers. Yeah, and thank you, Carmel, for taking up the call and joining the work that we're done. And just for anyone that's out there, if you guys are wanting to join us, if you guys got an idea on what you guys want to do, something that's been laid on your heart that we might be able to help you out with, please let us know. Or if you're out there and you think, oh, you know what, I can sponsor a show like that guy from Critical Flooring, or I mean Crucial Flooring Machine.
Crucial
Flooring. Okay, then just say, hey, I'll head us up. Or that just goes to help us pay for these subscriptions and just make us, you know, produce better shows. But aside from that, hey, I'm happy. My heart's content. Hopefully you guys are good. Please take care of yourselves, everyone. And Marshy, if you're out there, hopefully you guys have managed to find a medium to get your land back. But aside from that, it's once TC. What do we say, Carmel?
Always TC.
TC for life.
Let's go.